Convinced by all competing parties, voters in western Uttar Pradesh are all set to vote in the phase two of the state polls today. Phase one of the seven-phase assembly elections in the state ended on the 11th of February with 63% voter turnout. Phase two polls could hint as to which party would win the state. 11 districts will go to polls today, including Saharanpur, Bijnor, Moradabad, Sambas, Rampur, Bareilly, Amroha, Pilibhit, Khiri, Shahjahanpur and Badaun, with 721 candidates in the fray. Announcement of the results will be on the March 11th.
जब पहले फेज में गठबंधन की मजबूत स्थिति है तो निश्चित तौर पर उससे बेटर और बेटर और बेटर होता चला जाएगा, क्योंकि ये तो एक हवा है। जब हवा अच्छी चलती है तो नीचे तक वो और ज्यादा तूफान बनकर के चलती है, उसमें बहुत सारी विपक्षी पार्टियां उड़ जाएंगी और सिर्फ गठबंधन ही रह जाएगा।
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की परिवर्तन की जो लहर है, जो परिवर्तन का संदेश था, जो हमने अपनी परिवर्तन यात्राओं के माध्यम से दिया था, प्रधानमंत्री जी की परिवर्तन सभाओं के माध्यम से दिया था, और अब वो धीरे धीरे करके वो आधी बनती जा रही है, तूफान का रूप ले लेगी और आप देखेंगे कि जो 300 के पार का आंकड़ा है वो हमको प्राप्त होगा।
Now, in an exclusive interview to NewsX, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has lashed out at the politics of dynasty being practiced by some parties in the nation. He has said that the strength of a party depends on the strength of the leader and that dynasty politics leads to an erosion of ideologies. Take a listen in.
I think the Congress is a phasing out political phenomenon. There are three reasons that I see why the Congress is phasing out. A dynasty can be an asset on a party, it can be a liability. A party is as strong as the strength and the competence of that generation of the dynasty. So an Indira Gandhi or a Jawaharlal Nehru could make it strong. A Rahul Gandhi can take it where he has taken it today. So it is almost coexistent with the capacity of that generation of the dynasty. So I think now there are the diminishing returns of the dynasty. Secondly, I think dynasty also creates a peculiar situation where leadership stops growing. So you don't have state leaders. Who's their leader in UP? We are sitting here in Lucknow, so you can't instantly think of a name. Yeah. That's the problem. The third, I think the ideological dilution. What does it stand for? In 1991, it stood for liberalization and reforms. In UPA1, it stood for some kind of a left of center politics. Today, it has positioned itself as complete retrograde. So if you say subsidies must be targeted to the poor, they say we oppose Aadhaar. If you say black money must be eliminated, we oppose demonetization. If you come out with a liberalization step, they will be the only ones seeing opposing it. So I think there is a complete ideological blurredness which has taken place. So identity is lost, leadership creation has suffered, and the strength of the party is as weak as the current chain, which is the current strength of the generation of that dynasty.
This time, I'm stepping into a short breather. Stay tuned to NewsX. Lots more on the other side.